Hello everyone, greetings to you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Ni ay kublay pibaro at pagkating jo prajani uchi suktes.
Ham ap sabhi ko pranam karte hai Prabhu Yeshu ke naam mein.
Welcome you all to the online program of the Children's Ministry. Ni priyang sambhay pibaro sa ka online program chang ka Children's Ministry.
Ham ap sabhi ko swagat karte hai is Children's Ministry ke online karyakram mein.
To start this program, let us all read together from the Word of God from Psalm 67. Pagkabasdang tini ko program, tukin yun ikon kuli lang na kagpil kito uplay na kasam ko panhiyo kunyo.
Is karikram ko shuruat karte hai Prabhu ke vachan padne se jo bhajan sangita sarsat se parenge.
May God be gracious to us and bless us and make His face shine on us so that your ways may be known on earth, your salvation among all nations. May the people praise you, God. May all the people praise you. May the nations be glad and sing for joy, for you rule the people with equity and guide the nations of the earth. May the people praise you, God. May all the people praise you. The land yields its harvest. God, our God, blesses us. May God bless us still, so that all the ends of the earth will fear Him. Now, let us all pray together and commit this time to the Holy Spirit of God. Akini ka porpat tungin niya lay pagduway lang balban ay tiya ka porparo haumansin bukuwa chong lay.
Is samay ay ham iksat prakna karte hai or is pure samay ko pavitra atma ko sopte hai.
Father, we come before you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank you, God, for this opportunity that you've given us. We thank you for this time that you've given us, God. Once again, we commit ourselves to you. We commit this time to you. Take complete control of this time, Lord. Touch our hearts. Change our hearts, O God. Change our minds. And help us to live more for you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This time, let us all join together in praising and worshiping God. Akin ka por pat tungin yung lake dang panyaro abat bermani yung lake.
Is samay ham ek sa jurte hai Prabhu ke stuti aur aradhana ke liye.
stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. Our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. Our
I believe we have all been blessed by the praise and worship. Nangit kambing la yomad ikiching kuku, ling ba kiching yaro ba kiching mani yuble.
Hame vishwas hai ki hum sab aashishit hue Prabhu ki stuti aur aradhana se.
Now, let us all join together in praising God through the gifts He has given His children as they present to us with special numbers. Akan ika por patung ini bersnok tilang bagi hep kibadet akaban mani yublay ling ba kisap kiba ublay i ay shiki.
So ab, aye hum sab ek saath judte hai Prabhu ki stuti karne mein jo bachcho ke hunar se jo Prabhu ne use diye hai.
Everywhere I go.
105. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Thank you.
us allow God to search our hearts and to transform us today as we listen to His Word. Tuhan yang kasih dan ayah dari play buat tinggalah yang kecil yang berjuni kat bagi sengap dan ketidian yang berjauh.
Tuh, ham aj prabhu ko hamare dilo ko khojne ki anumati de aur hame bande jaise hum uske vachan ko sunte hain.
Welcome to Hartford, home of a million hearts. Our story is about one of those hearts. This heart. He has a tongue, as all hearts do, linked together always. This is a story about friendship and betrayal and redemption. While these two muscles are equally strong, the heart is the boss. Here's how it works. Whatever is in the heart comes out through his friend. Now the tongue can be wild and destructive. It's just how tongues are. But this pair needs one another. They are partners for life. And when they play in harmony, the results are beautiful. But the streets of Hartford can be mean, and trouble lurks around every corner. Everyone knows that if you listen to a stomach long enough, you'll eventually give in. Just one smidge of poison won't hurt, the heart tells himself, but deception is deception, no matter the dose. Just like that, the restless evil is growing. The moment a heart thinks he has his tongue under control is precisely when the beast finds a new way to strike. The tongue is small. How could it destroy so much? Well, friend, let's get this straight. No matter the distance, virtual or not, no matter how private, the tongue's damage is real. Heart and tongue push and pull, striving for power. Heart is getting weaker, while tongue grows stronger. Perhaps a third party could talk some sense into them. After all, brain has solved complex problems before, but this time is different. It seems this town's not big enough for the three of them, and brain is no match for a street-fighting tongue.
Fight!
Pay close attention, because heart doesn't see it. Each sip of elixir hardens heart. He's not alone in this struggle. All tongues can be dangerous. Every last one. I can do this, heart tells himself. Heart is right, kind of. Tongues can be controlled, but never for long. No heart can tame a tongue all by itself. Tongues want nothing more than to be set free. You can't simply hold them down. Why does heart cling tightly to the poison? Hearts love what is good, but they love what is familiar more. Heart can claim his tongue means no harm, but it's too late. Heart is in bondage. No change required. One tongue can destroy an entire city. Heart, unable to stop the monster, grows cold. There is no room for joy now, only hate. This isn't the first time a tongue has destroyed a heart, and it won't be the last. How did we get here? It starts with one drop of poison. The heart can't even fix itself, so how could it stop a raging tongue? Enter wisdom. The fix is external, one sent from above. It takes grace to heal a heart of stone, and only a healed heart can control his tongue. Hearts and tongues are a powerful duo. They can destroy and they can bless. There is good news. Restoration is underway. So what about your story? The story of your heart and tongue.
Coming out of our mouth. It is only God's help, and He is our only hope, which will help us to control or tame our tongue. We can see this from James chapter 3, verses 1 to 12.
Kapang minkran hangasni, kaday shapang kumno ba nginla pansinshar yaw tylliej. Kumngitib bau thili jongi udeu barit tam e nik de khot mat ki jongi hinre u don pat ka bor ka khrao ka jing em ka jongi u apostle jacob u tho shibon shapang kum no ban te lakam ya u thili but they tang ka jing pan la u try u blay be la ken ban te lakam ye u nin shiam na ka jacob kalam nang ba lai ka de khot ka baning kong hado ka ba khat ar
आज का विषय है अपनी जबान या जीभ पर नियंत्रण रखना। जैसे कि हम जानते हैं कि हमारा जीभ शरीर के सबसे छोटे अंगों में से एक है, परंतु हमारे जीवन में इसका सामर्थ्य अधिक है। प्रेरित याकूब ने कुछ निराशाजनक बातें कही है हमारे मुंह से निकलने वाले शब्दों के विषय में। केवल परमेश्वर के द्वारा और उनके सहायता से ही हम अपने जीभ पर नियंत्रण रख सकते हैं। याकूब 3:1-12 हमें इसी विषय में सिखाता है।
God created each of us for a specific reason, but one of the most important ones is to tell others about Jesus Christ and how to receive salvation through belief in Him. The Apostle James warned that we should be eager to be teachers of God's word because we would be held to a higher standards.
Blame thao yin ni na ga ta jing mo jong u ndrai ko wei ko kong san tam ka long bang ni thu i wei shao jisu but kun no ban yo i jing pen em da ka pa kai o apostle jacob kwa ini mengelikai ke ketian ublei yang merdaka dan rakno ini syaka waipat ke gerdan.
Permishwar ne hame kai khas yojna ke anusar banaya hai, lekin unmein se sabse khas yah hai ki hum anya logo ko yeshu masih ke vishay mein bataye aur yeshu ke dwara udhar kaise praapt kiya jaye uske bare mein bataye. Prerit Yaakob ne कहा कि हमें परमेश्वर का वचन सिखाने में उत्सुक होना चाहिए ताकि वह महिमा के दूसरे स्तर तक हमें ले जा सके.
We all fail in many areas, especially with our words, but it is possible to learn to control our words so that they reflect our belief and God's mission for our lives.
Ni baro ni hab no hakajing em ka jongi kam tam dagi ktien ka bengi kren hendrei ka long pat ka bala bengin te lakam mi ktien ki jongi khnang ba kan phalang ka jing thmu ublei ha ka jing em ka jongi
apne shabdon ke karan hum kai bar gir jate hain lekin hum apne shabdon ko niyantran mein rakh sakte hain taki vah hamare vishwas aur हमारे जीवन के प्रति परमेश्वर की योजना को दर्शाए.
As an example, James tells us that horses don't start out their lives as gentle trained animals. They are wild creatures with huge, powerful bodies, but with some train and some things as small as bits and brittle in their mouth. We can control the direction of these animals. So, by controlling our words, we can control the power and directions as well. James continued describing how sailing ships are amazing and they can cross huge bodies of water and carries enormous goods and supplies. Though these vessels are driven by fierce wind, they can be directed by a tiny rudder, steered by a single person.
Kung kanuksa o Jacob o yatho shini, bagi kulai ki deki mrat ki bahaya, bagi beran kam bante lakam shwai ka shintur jongki, khenang ban pin ko ngu yaki. Kung taru o thaliyaj o long tang idukhot ibarit, hindrei o syat keran kharau ya, hakami katno ka shis taiba ki ding idang ibarit ibapen me no. Hakami iru, ya ka liyang ba, ka bakharau kata-kata, bat balabe ru yaki dakal air bajur air pen ban la pen phai yalam yaki da ki boy tha ki berit air shano shano ru kat bamon ka jingthmu babat boy tha.
Udharan ke taur pe prerit Yaakob ne sikhaya ki ghora janam se hi shant aur komal swabhav ka nahi hota. Ve jangli hote hain lekin thode parikshan aur chote se lagam ke dwara unhein sawari ke niyantran anusar chalaya ja sakta hai. Isi tarah apne jeev par niyantran rakhkar hum apne jeevan ko sahi disha mein le ja sakte hain. Prerit Yaakob ne ek aur udharan dete hue kaha ki samudra jahaz कितने अद्भुत होते हैं और विशाल समुद्र पर पार कर जाते हैं और कई विशाल वस्तुएं भी उठा लेते हैं. यह विशाल जहाज समुद्र की लहरों द्वारा प्रभावित हो जाते हैं लेकिन एक छोटे से पतवार से उसे नियंत्रण में लाया जा सकता है.
We can accomplish great things and persevere in stormy times if we can control the words we speak. The tongue we use to speak is small, and in many ways it is the most dangerous parts of our bodies. James tells us, just as a tiny spark can set the whole forest on fire, a single evil word the tongue spit out can start a destructive fire, can do an unimaginable damage. However, just as our words can corrupt our lives and stir of all kinds of evil, they can also do an incredible goods.
Nila banle shibun ki ehi e, but banla ru banyeng haba one lin shop ke eryong ke jing im. Lada haba ngila bante lakam ya kiktien ki bangikren. Uthliyej bangikren ulong uberit duo. Hendray ulong pat bosir kay haduk kata-kata. U Jacob uang bakumba ipliak ding berit ila bantang noy ke kalau barok away. Tekum taru ke ketien ke bengikren kala ban sedang ya ke ding bosir kay haduk kata-kata ke bangimla ban mudur.
हम कई सफलता प्राप्त कर सकते हैं और तूफान के समय में धीरज धर सकते हैं यदि हम अपने शब्दों को सही तरह से इस्तेमाल करें। हमारा जीभ बहुत ही छोटा है लेकिन यह अधिक खतरनाक अंग भी है हमारे शरीर का। प्रेरित याकूब ने कहा कि जैसे एक छोटा सा चिंगारी पूरे जंगल को राख में बदल सकता है, उसी तरह हमारे मुँह से निकला हुआ एक दुष्ट शब्द विनाशकारी कार्य कर सकता है, लेकिन जिस तरह एक शब्द हमारे जीवन को नष्ट कर सकता है, वैसे ही यह अविश्वसनीय भले काम भी कर सकता है।
Next, James had us consider animals from reptiles to birds and creatures of the sea, beasts of the jungle, humans has tamed and trained every kind of animals. The only thing humans unable to tame is their own tongue. To keep them from speaking evil. It has deadly potential to spew out poison-filled words, wounding all who hear them. Consider this on Sunday. We go to church, where we use our tongue to speak and sing praises to God, and then a few hours later we speak words that curse another person who was made in God's image. 1 minute our tongue are doing what they are created, and next they are acting out of evil. This should never be. Good and evil cannot come from the same place. Can apple trees, bears, oranges, or salt water ponds produce fresh water? No. So a Christian should not use evil words.
Ubriu ulala mpen kongwo ya jan baro ki jat marat ki bedon ha ka ka rengkau bar ka sun beneng hendrei tang ya laut liet om shim lala mpen kongwo ni kren ki ktien ki besniu ki belong kum ka bi ban pen sosi ya ki wei perkat pi ha ki singi ublei ni yaro ni mane ya ublei da ka shintor ka jongi hendrei tangi khinyat kentapan ni krens ni ki wei pat ki brio ki bedon ki belong ha ka jing thau ka jong ublei hi.
याकूब ने एक और उदाहरण दिया कि चाहे आसमां के उड़ने वाले पक्षी हो, जमीन पर रेंगने वाले जीव हो या जल में रहने वाले जीव, मनुष्य ने उन सभी को नियंत्रण में कर लिया है, परंतु केवल जीव को कोई नियंत्रण में न कर सका। वह एक ऐसा बला है जो कभी रुकता नहीं, वह प्राण नाशक विष से भरी हुई है। मान लीजिए कि रविवार को हम कलीसिया जाते हैं, जहां हम अपने शब्दों के द्वारा परमेश्वर की प्रशंसा और महिमा गाते हैं, और कुछ समय बाद हम अपने शब्दों द्वारा किसी को शाप देते हैं जिसे परमेश्वर के स्वरूप में ही रचा गया है। एक क्षण में हमारा जीव वह करता है जिसके लिए उसे रचाया गया था, और दूसरे ही क्षण में हम इसके द्वारा दुष्टता के काम करते हैं। यह हो नहीं सकता। भलाई और बुराई एक ही जगह से नहीं आ सकते। क्या एक सेब का पेड़ संतरा दे सकता है या समुद्र मीठा पानी दे सकता है? नहीं। इस कारण एक ईसाई को दुष्ट शब्दों का प्रयोग नहीं करना चाहिए। हमारे शब्द परमेश्वर की महिमा के लिए होने चाहिए और भक्तिपूर्ण जीवन दर्शाना चाहिए। बाइबल हमें बताती है कि यीशु परमेश्वर का वचन है जो देहधारी बन गया। यीशु वह उदाहरण है जिसके अनुसार हमें जीवन व्यतीत करना है, ताकि हमारा जीवन उनके भलाई कामों के विषय में प्रचार करता रहे।
Our words should honor God and reflect that godly lives. The Bible tells us that Jesus was the Word of God, became flesh. Jesus is our example to follow. And our lives should speak and live out the good works of God. I would like to share a few of the verses from the Bible. Let's see what the Bible says about controlling the tongue, and let it encourage you to speak blessings and life to everyone around you. Let it encourage you and let the Holy Spirit help you control your tongue.
Kikatian jongi ki day ban pern buram ya ublay bathaba pat ya ka jinglong jong o ka bible ka yathu engi bau jisu long uktien ublay ubawan ha ka jinglong do u jisu uday ka nuksa yangi bangin bot bat ka jing in jongi ka day ban kren ya ki kam babha jong u baro ngakwa banya sambat phi katuk ni git khon nagak tien ublay tungin pen ayu ka don ban ong shaphang kumno ban te lakam ya uthli bat kan pen shluru ipi kumno ban kran ye ki jingkar khu bat ai ba umun se mo khoj uni rap ipi ban te lakam ya la uthli
main bible se kuch vachan aapko dena chahungi चलिए देखते हैं कि बाइबल हमें जीव को वश में करने के विषय में क्या बताती है और मैं आशा करती हूँ कि इसके द्वारा आप दूसरों के लिए आशीष और जीवन का शब्द बोल सके। पवित्र आत्मा आपको सहायता करे ताकि आप अपने जीव को वश में कर सके।
The following verses, James chapter 3 verse 10 says, From the same mouth come blessing and cursing, my brother, These things ought not to be so.
Dong in pet yi de khat nakak tin ublay ka ba kranj phang u thli. In pai na ka jokap ka lenong ba lai ka de khat ka ba shiphau ko ong na ka ju yi ka shuntor ka mi ka jingkar khu bar ka jingtem kam dei ko parabanga jonga yakini ki ki ei ru ban long kumta.
To chaliye dekhte hain. Yakub 3 ka 10 kehta hai एक ही मुंह से स्तुति और शाप दोनों निकलते हैं हे मेरे भाइयों ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए
I'll also read from Psalm 37 verse 30 It says the mouth of the righteous utters wisdom and his tongue speaks justice
Naga Psalm ka balai phunyo ko khot ka balai phau ko ong ka shinturu bohok ka kren ya ka jing stan baro thali jong u ukren ya ka jing bishar
साथ ही भजन संहिता 37 का 30 कहता है धर्मी अपने मुंह से बुद्धि की बातें करता है और न्याय के वचन कहता है
We move on Colossians chapter 4 verse 6 Let your speech always be gracious seasoned with salt so that you may know how to answer each person
कशिती उपोल Shaki Colossae glenong basao kar khot ban rio ko ang ai ba ka jingkran jong phi hala ka smi kan long da ka ba jali jo om bala panthiang da ka malo ba phin yo tip kum no phi dei ban ye pan phai ktin ha uwei po wei ba ro
aur aage badhte hue Colossae 4 ka 6 kehta hai तुम्हारे वचन सदा अनुग्रह सहित और सुहाना हो कि तुम्हें हर मनुष्य को उचित रीति से उत्तर देना आ जाए
Again Proverbs chapter 31 verse 26 says She opens her mouth with wisdom and the teachings of kindness is on her tongue
ka proverb kalenong ka balai phuwei ka khat ka bar phun riyo ko ang ka ang yala ka shintor ha ka jing stat bat ka an ka jing les bon ha uthali jong ka
aur niti vachan 31 ka 26 kehta hai va buddhi ki baat bolti hai aur uske vachan kripa ki shiksha ke anusar hote hai
and then proverb chapter 15 verse 28 says The heart of the righteous ponders, Ho, to answer by the mouth of the wicked, pours out evil things.
Ka Proverbs, kaba khatsan kadkhat kaba arphupra ka ong ka donut ubahak ka perkhat ya kaban phaik tien hindrei ka shintor jong boman ka shuthe no ya ki ek ek ki basniyo.
Aur saath hi niti vachan 15 ka 28 kehta hai धर्मी मन में सोचता है कि क्या उत्तर दूं परंतु दुष्टों के मुंह से बुरी बातें उबल आती है
Then Proverb 25 verse 28 says A man without self control is like a city broken into and let without walls
का प्रोवर्ब अर्पुसन kadakhat ka phupra ka ong uta ubom don ka jingkhang yala ka mansiem ulongkum ka nongba ka blatwa bar ka bom don kandro
niti vachan 25 ka 28 kehta hai jiski atma vash mein nahi vah aise nagar ke saman hai jiski shaharpana gherao karke tod di gayi ho.
Then James chapter 1 verse 21 says, therefore put away all filthiness and rampant wickedness and receive the meekness, the implanted words, which is able to save your soul.
Ka shithi Jacob kalanong ka baningkong ka dukhar ka baar huwai ka ong na bakumta habala buono bari ka jintingit baro bari ya ka jing shilay ka jing bishni topin padiang da ka jing jam nod ya ka takaktiin blathong kabala ken panpin im yaki mensim jong phi.
Saath hi Yaakob 1 ka 21 kehti hai, isliye sari malinta aur बैर भाव की बढ़ती को दूर करो, उस वचन को नम्रता से ग्रहण कर लो जो हृदय में बोया गया और तुम्हारे प्राणों का उद्धार कर सकता है.
So I would like to encourage you all, don't give up, keep on trying day after day, start anew. Taming the tongue is incredibly very hard, but these verses tell us to pray for wisdom, self-control and patience. So let's praise God and receive His word, for His word is active, is living, sharper than any two-edged swords. May God bless you all.
Ting ang kunslur yupi, bapimday ban mantan, ban persyang ban te lakam yaw thalid. Ban te lakam yaw thalid, kalong shisha ka ba ea. Hindray kini kitukot, ki ong bangiday ban duway, ya ka jingstan, kabor haladihi bat kabor jong ka jingyai sha ni pidyang ya ka ktien ublai na mar ka long ba im bat ka banab kum ka wat lam aryang sirti to ublai unkar khu ye phi.
Main aap sabhi ko utsahit karna chahti hu ki haar mat maniye, koshish karte rahiye din pratidin. Apni jeev ko niyantran mein karna kathin to hai, lekin यह वचने बुद्धि, संयम और धीरज को खोजना सिखाते हैं. तो चलिए परमेश्वर की प्रशंसा करें और उनके शब्दों को प्राप्त करें, क्योंकि उनके शब्द सक्रिय, सामर्थी और कोई भी दोधारी तलवार से अधिक तेज है. परमेश्वर आप सभी को आशीष दे.
We have come to the end of this program. Thank you for staying with us to the end. Ni apa yang sebab kod jangka ni ke program, kubli si pun dan tingkat bagi hadu bab kod jangka.
Is karikram ke antni pahunc di, or aap sabi ko dhanyawad dite hai, ki aap ant tak hamare saath bani rehne ke liye.
Let us pray. May the love of God the Father, the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each and every one of us, now and forevermore. Amen.